ready to worship. You need God. And you know you need God today. So let's just lift our hands in this place this morning. Father God, we worship you. We worship you with our being here. You said, Father God, that you would satisfy the seeker. And we've come to seek you today, Lord. Thank you for your presence in this place. You've come to meet with us. Thank you, Lord God, that Holy Spirit, you're already at work. You're already doing what you've come to do, to bring life and freedom and healing and joy and deliverance, because that's who you are. So, Father, we worship you for who you are, and we give you praise and we give you thanks in this place. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's put our hands together and just give him praise this morning. He's an awesome God. Let's thank him for what he's done. Thank you, Lord.
My Savior, Redeemer, lifted me from the miry clay. Almighty, forever, I will never be the same, 'cause you came near from the
atmosphere today. My heart has been so heavy this week watching what's going on, but you know what I remembered? I remembered a wise evangelist. You probably know Harold Chamberlain. And he said to me, Candy,
No matter how it looks in the physical, it's not what's happening in the spiritual. And the Lord said, Candy, get your eyes off what you're seeing and get on your knees and pray it through. Pray it through, because I'm moving. I'm moving. And even though it may look like this isn't going the way I thought it would, it is. God is doing something. He won't stop now because he made us a promise. Amen? Oh God, he won't stop now.
I give you glory for all you've brought me through, and now I'm ready for whatever you want to do. I'm moving forward to follow after you, and now I'm ready for whatever you want to do. Your presence is an open door. We want you, Lord, like never before. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before. In every season, your grace has been enough, and I'm believing the best is yet to come.
The best is yet to come.
The cross before me, my hope on things above, and in you, Jesus, the best is yet to come. You, Lord, like
presence is almost knocking me right off my feet. Amen. I just want him. He's the king of my heart.
You are. so good. God, you're so you're so
saying. When I was meditating and praying about what songs to choose today, and leading up this whole week, Holy, Holy, Holy came on my heart because it reminds me a lot of our anthem. So much. We sing the words of our anthem that are so majestic, but God is he's the most majestic, amen? And when I think about early morning, we rise to thee, and our anthem says glowing hearts, and it talks about rising too. And I just made this correlation. I'm like, God, I know that you're in control, and I trust you. I trust you. But right now, I just want to lay on the floor and just worship my majestic God today. So when you sing these words today, think about how majestic your King is. The same King that's going to deliver our land. Amen.
Voices unto God today. Come on. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. God, you're so good. God, you are so good. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I can't hear the church today. Where's the church? Come on, where's the church of the living God today? Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, where's the church of the living God today? Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on. We have the victory. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory to God. Hallelujah. God, you're so good. Sing that again. Hallelujah. And
God, you're so good.
God, you're so good.
God, you're so good. You're so good.
Come on, let's give God praise.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. This is why, the prophetic word is so important. This is why the church needs prophecy. The Bible says prophecy is for the edification and the building up of the church. Yes. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah.
Yes.
What we are witnessing in our land, if it wasn't for a prophetic word, it would look hopeless. But because God has given us a prophetic word, we know everything's going to be okay. Somebody say praise God. And the Lord told us it was going to be a year of challenges with many breakthroughs. And the Lord told us that the reign of Mr. Trudeau will come to an end. And the Lord told us all of these things. So now our faith is not by what we see. Our faith is by what we heard and what we now believe. Somebody say, praise God. Oh, so I'm taking my eyes off of all of that. And I'm focusing our attention on the Lord who is able to perform His word. Come on, somebody. He's able to perform His word. Hallelujah. Will you lift up your hands today and bless Him? Come on, will you lift up your hands onto heaven and bless the living God? Hallelujah. And sing this again with us. God, you are so good. To me, praise God. Let's sing it again. God, you are so good. And God,
you're so good.
Hallelujah.
God, you're so good. God, you're so good.
And you're so that song, hallelujah. The song, hallelujah. Praise God. Don't get quiet now. Don't stop. Y'all looking at me. Don't look at me. I'll just look right back at you. We're looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Come on. God is bigger than all of this mess. Come on. God is bigger than all of this mess. Oh, praise God. How about you? But I got the joy of the Lord today. Come on, hallelujah. I got the joy of the Lord. And we're looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And we know God will bring and is bringing a great victory to the land. Oh, hallelujah. We're not going to Parliament. We're going to the throne of God today. Come on, we're going to His throne today. The Bible says, hallelujah, come boldly before me through the blood of my Son. Come to the throne of grace to receive help in a time of trouble. We're going to the throne of God today as a church. Praise God. Sing this with us as Pastor Amber leads us in it. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. him.
Hallelujah.
Sing it to him online. Sing it online right now. Praise God. You, Jesus.
Lord, I love
the people love you, Lord. You. Hallelujah. We love you. Praise God.
Lord, I love
oh, Jesus.
You.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God.
Lord, I love
thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Before the throne of Jesus, sing hallelujah. Together for the Lord. Come on. Clap your hands, all ye people, and shout. Come on, shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Hallelujah. 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 Canada shall and is being saved. The hand of God is moving. The Holy Ghost is working. Oh, don't stop. Look at you. There you go, looking at me again. That's the problem with church today. It's become such a performance. We're waiting for the performer to perform. Come on. You are anointed of God to declare the wondrous works of Jesus in the house. Come on. We need to hear your voice and your confession of faith. If this was a concert, I would have sold tickets, and you would have left after 5 minutes feeling ripped off at the power of this voice singing. But this is not a concert. This is a holy provocation and a gathering of the saints of God. Hallelujah. This is God dwelling with his people and God working through his people. The Holy Ghost is moving in the land. Come on, the Holy Spirit is moving in Canada. You say, Pastor, it didn't look like it. He's moving in Canada. I don't go by what I see. I go by what I heard, and I go by what I know. God is moving in Canada. Say that. God is moving in Canada. Come on, say it. God is moving in Canada. Say it again. God is moving in Canada. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come on. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Gracias, Santo Espiritu. Gracias. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come on, stay. Get in the Holy Spirit. Come on. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, sweet Spirit of God. Play that song. Hallelujah. Come, Holy Spirit. Ramba koshombaha satamahete. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, sweet, precious Spirit, we need thee. Hallelujah. Come on, get in the Holy Spirit. Come on, just worship. Just worship. Just talk. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, sweet Spirit, I pray. Come in thy strength and thy power.
Come, Holy Spirit, I need thee.
Sing that if you know it. Hallelujah.
Come, sweet Spirit, I pray.
Come to Canada.
Come in thy strength and thy power.
Oh, if you'll come, come, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, sing it again. Hallelujah.
Come, Holy Spirit.
We need thee.
I need thee.
This nation needs you, Holy Spirit.
And come, sweet Spirit, I pray.
The song says, come in thy strength and thy power. Away. Hallelujah.
Come in thine own.
Oh, you're getting it. You're getting it. Come on, keep singing it. Come, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And
come, Holy Spirit.
We need thee.
I need
This nation needs the power of the Holy Spirit. I watched this week proudful, arrogant men and women stand in this nation thinking that they possess the power to do what they're doing. I come to realize that they're just mere mortals who stand in with their own futile mentality. Not knowing that when God releases this power of the Holy Spirit, no man can resist it, and no man can stop the move of God's Spirit. Somebody say, praise God. Church, we take our eyes off of these people. The gods of this world are falling. And the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is rising in the land. And the church has to call on the help of the Holy Spirit right now. For God has not given us the spirit of this world. Neither has he given us the spirit of fear. But he has given us the precious Holy Spirit. For Jesus said, I must go that he might come. Oh, hallelujah. And surely he has come to the church. But now the church must call on the presence of the Holy Spirit to touch the land. Hallelujah. Somebody say, praise God. We're going to sing this song two more times. And I want you to speak by faith over this land. Come, Holy Spirit. Come to Ottawa. Come to Toronto. Come to Vancouver. Come to St. John's. Come to Charlottetown. Come on, somebody. Come to Halifax. Come to Manitoba and Calgary and Edmonton. Come to Regina. Come to Saskatoon. Come to Yellowknife. Come, Holy Spirit, across this land. Oh, hallelujah. Breathe, Holy Spirit, across this land. Deliver us, we pray. Oh, hallelujah. Let Canada fulfill her destiny in the name of Jesus. Will you lift your hands to heaven again? I know it might be new to some of you, but there's something about lifting your hands. The Bible says it's like the evening sacrifice. Oh, hallelujah. Sing this one more time with us as we call on the presence of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. Go ahead, Pastor Amber. Thank you. Oh, yes, Lord. Sing it with all of your heart. Sing it by faith. Hallelujah. Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit, I need thee.
Come on, let me hear the church sing. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah.
Come in thy strength and thy
Hallelujah. The Lord is good. Come on, the Lord is good. Why don't you go around, tell 10 people for me. Just say this, Canada is being saved. Go around, tell 10 people and join your confession of faith together and tell them Canada is being saved. Hallelujah. Canada is being saved. Canada is being saved. Yes, yes. God bless you. May be seated. But then we would used to go on and sing, to me, he is so wonderful. How many remember that song? To me, isn't he wonderful?
He is so wonderful.
Oh, praise God.
To me, he is so wonderful.
Yes, there you go. Pastor Amber knows these songs.
First, love me.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
To me, he is so wonderful. To me, he is so wonderful.
Oh, I love him, don't you?
To me, he is so wonderful.
Remember that song.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
Come on, I feel like singing a little bit today.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
One thing that oppression always tries to do is to take away your song. It always tries to take away your song. You remember the children of Israel when they were up there in Babylon? And they said, sing to us the songs of Zion. And they said, how can we sing the songs of Zion in a strange land? And the Bible says they hung their harps upon the willow, meaning that they went into great sorrow. And that's what oppression tries to do. It tries to put you into sorrow and to hopelessness. But something about singing unto the Lord and making melody in your heart and rejoicing in the goodness of God that lifts oppression right off of you. Somebody say amen. And I told you at the beginning of this year, ain't nobody going to break my stride. Ain't nobody going to break my stride. Are you kidding me? I ain't going to let no politician take the joy of the Lord out of my heart. Come on, praise God. They want my source to start with. Jesus was my source from the day that he saved me in 1987. Somebody say praise God. Oh, listen, some of you still don't look happy. Would you smile at your neighbor and tell him everything's gonna be all right? Come on, why don't you smile at a few more other people and tell them everything's gonna be all right. What's that? Everything's gonna be all. I got a feeling. Do you know that? You know that song? I can't sing. I said these people, if they bought tickets for my concert, they would feel ripped off. Praise God, hallelujah! But don't let them get you down. People say, Pastor, didn't you see all those police and everything on the streets? Well, you all are determined to sing this song, aren't you? Can I finish what I was saying? I'm teasing. But everybody says, you see all those cops and military on the street? Last time I checked, heaven's got a pretty big one. Yeah. I pray for those cops. I pray for the military. I pray for them all. We do. We pray for them. But God's in charge, folks. Look to your neighbor and say, relax. God's in charge. Come on, tell somebody, relax. Come on, relax. God's got this. Come on, God's got this. Some of you are looking at me like, heaven's in trouble. Heaven's not in trouble. God's got this. Heaven's not in crisis right now. Praise God. Heaven, I guess I'm going to have to preach along that line. Heaven's not in trouble. Will you tell somebody else that? Heaven's not in trouble right now. Sometimes I picture God just sitting on the throne going, see, we think God's late, but he's always on time. Somebody say, praise God. Hallelujah. God's always on time. It's us who pace back and forth. God says, well, it's just about time. God's always on time. Listen. None of this moves God at all. God knows it. And we have the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Somebody say amen, amen. Somebody say amen. I know you all want to sing that song, but I have to preach. And if you sing that song, I may never get to preach. But I do want to encourage you along these lines real quick. James chapter 2. It's not what I'm preaching on. But I do want to encourage you, actually, go to the book of James. James chapter 1, actually. I want you to wrap your faith today around everything. Everything that God has promised. Wrap your faith around it. Say that. I'm going to wrap my faith around it. You guys can keep playing softly, though. I'm going to wrap my faith around it. Say that. I'm going to wrap my faith around the promises of God. Come on. Hallelujah. You're going to find out quickly making God your source was the best decision you could have ever made. Somebody say amen to that. I'm making God my source. Hallelujah. People say, well, Mr. Trudeau's freezing money. Yeah, but heaven isn't freezing anything for you. Heaven is releasing his blessing upon your life. Yeah, but they'll try to stop it. No man can stop what God releases in the earth. Somebody say, praise God. Oh, come on. I got to encourage your faith. I can feel it today. But it's okay. Hallelujah. Wrap your faith around the promises of God. And we're going to get ready to receive our tithe and offering. And I felt this morning in prayer, God said, tell my people to wrap their faith as they come down here to give. Now, I haven't spoken like this in a long time. But I'm here to tell you right now, wrap your faith on what you release out of your hand today into the work of the ministry. Wrap your faith around it. Say, I'm wrapping my faith around it. Oh, that was so weak. If I was the devil, I wouldn't be afraid at all. Come on. I'm wrapping my faith around it. I'm wrapping my faith around that promise of God. And when I release out of my hand today, the Lord shall multiply the very thing that I've let go. Come on, somebody, praise God. But they're worried about the economy and all this. Get your mind off of that. That's their economy. It's not your economy. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm not old, but I am middle-aged. David said, I was young and now I am old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken. Come on, somebody. I have never, say that with me, I have never seen the righteous forsaken. See, I got to get you speaking. If you don't speak, nothing's going to happen. But some of you say, well, I don't speak. Well, you must be. Some of you do speak. And you got to be careful to what you say. I have never seen the righteous forsaken. Or God's seed begging for bread. Is that not the word of God? Come on, is that the word of God today? Is that the word of God today, church? It is. That's the word of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the Bible tells us, the Bible is very clear. If any man, verse 5, lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. Really, he that is wavering in their faith is driven by everything that goes on in life. But the man or woman of faith is not moved by what happens in the world or happens by life or happens by unexpected things. The man or woman of God is moved by the promise of God and wraps their faith around that promise and puts their trust in what God has said. And that's us as a church today. Somebody say praise God. Come on, I got to lift you up today. I feel it, Pastor. You feel that? I feel like I'm going to lift your faith up today. Forget about Mr. Trudeau for a second. God will deal with this man. I said, God will deal with this man. Forget about it all. Look to your neighbor and go Italian for a second. Forget about it. Wrap your faith upon what God said. And God said, give and it will be given. Press down. I've seen some of you at Mandarin Buffet. You get as much on that plate. You don't realize you can go back as many times as you want, but you're going to get it all on the first shot. How many know what I'm talking about? How many have ever seen those people at Mandarin? That thing is mile high. Dr. Paz put his hand up and said, that's me. You get as much on that plate as you can. That's what God said. He said, wrap your faith upon what I said. Give and it will be given unto you. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Say, I don't know, Pastor. This is a tough time. That's the world. That's not you. That's God's word is true. And God said, tell my people to wrap their faith right now around what I'm promising. And they're going to be just fine. Look to your neighbor and say, you're going to be just fine. Oh, my goodness. Hallelujah. Look to your neighbor and say, you're going to be just fine. That was, tell your neighbor, that was weak. Thank you.
It'll be just dandy.
Thank you. Everything's going to be just fine. God is, yeah, there you go. Thank you. Everything's going to be just fine. Because you're wrapping your faith upon what God said. And if God said it, it shall surely happen. Somebody say, praise God. So if God says, let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For wisdom, you're going to ask in faith, nothing wavering, for God to supply all of your needs and to make sure you're more than blessed in this time of all human history. Somebody say amen. Let's stand to our feet. Are you ready to give?
Yes.
We're not doing the left and the right. You just come celebrate Jesus, make a confession of faith, and expect God to do something in your life. God bless you as you come and give. Guys, you better hurry up. They're going to run over you.
I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright.
somebody sent me a video. How many saw that? In Ottawa, late last night, they had a street party, and people were dancing and jumping and celebrating. How many of you saw that late last night? They're shouting on the streets of Ottawa. And we're trying to get you church folks shouting in the house of God today. Somebody say praise God. Now listen, one more time. Stand to your feet. Sing this song, praise God. And move your feet for a second. Will you do that? Move your feet. Look to your neighbor and say, can you move your feet? Come on, just move your feet a little bit. Just, come on. Come on, the Lord is good. Can you do it there? Look at Gord. I've never seen Gord do that before. He's moving. Praise God. Go ahead and sing it one more time.
I've got a promise. Everything's going to be all right. Oh,
everything's gonna be all right. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, everything's gonna be all right.
Yes.
God is in control. Say this with me. Lord, I believe your word. I wrap my faith around your promise. And you said give, and it will be given unto me. And I believe that word. I speak it by faith. This will happen for me in my house. Oh, hallelujah. And I speak by faith. Pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men and women give into my bosom. I am blessed. I wrap my faith and say I am blessed and highly favored. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, somebody. I feel faith coming into your heart. Hallelujah. I am blessed and we are blessed and we are highly favored. In Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, high five somebody and say, I am blessed. And I am highly favored. Thank you, sir. Maybe I should hang on to it, please. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm blessed and I am highly favored. Say that again. I'm blessed. Say it again. I'm blessed and I'm highly favored. Say it again. I'm blessed and I am highly favored. Man, we could leave on that. I am blessed and I am highly favored. Oh, praise God. Isn't God good? Come on. You're getting it. I'm proud of you. You're getting it. Amen. Faith moves God. Say that with me. Faith moves God. Faith moves God. And right now, God needs a people of faith. Praise God. Amen. Oh, none of this is getting to me. I'm telling you what, don't let it get to you either. I was watching it the other day and I just said, you all don't realize who we serve. Praise God. We serve an awesome God. Let me fix this mic here. It's all over the place. There it is. God is good. Welcome online. If you're joining us online, we're celebrating here. I hope you're celebrating at home the goodness of God. Amen. And I just want to say we welcome everybody who joins us every week online, but we also welcome everyone, even all the people that drive so far to come to Hamilton, to this church. We are so grateful you're a part of our family for the sacrifice that you make to be here every single week. And for the entire family, we welcome you, we love you, and we bless you in the name of Jesus. I don't have much announcements today. I just want to say a couple of things. One is we got some favor, thank God. The people that own this property have said we can stay to the end of March now. So we're here another 4 weeks. Okay, so don't go to the high school on the first Sunday of March. Come here. Say, I'm coming here, so I know you heard me. You're coming here. You're coming here, because I don't want anybody to go to the high school the first Sunday of March. So here we are. God's left us in this building for another month. Some folks think we're never leaving. We'll see. Praise God. But thank God that they are giving us that wonderful opportunity. Amen. Don't forget the book sales out back, all of the funds that are going to the school in Pakistan in the honor of Pastor David Rutledge. Please go out there and buy those books and give them away. Just give them to people. Some people need the gospel. Amen. Some Christians need encouraging right now. Isn't that true? Some Christians really need encouraging right now. And so go out there and bless people, praise God, and help them in their life by giving them the word of God. God is moving, family, and I'm super excited. Everything that God began to reveal to me at the end of last year is really, really happening right now. What's that? Oh, tax receipts too. Oh, go get your money from Justin Trudeau as fast as you can. I woke up this morning and said, my taxes will be done tomorrow morning because that rascal ain't taking my return. Somebody say amen. So if you need your tax receipts, they're out there. Go see Peggy Sue after service today. She has them. Thank you, Peggy. Amen. And might as well get all you can and get all you get. Praise God. But, you know, I tell you, everything God showed me is playing out. So I'm super excited because I know what God showed me that was playing out and what is going to happen. And so that means if the first part of what God revealed to me was true, then the second part must be true. Somebody say amen. The second part must be true. Because God is not a man that he should lie, neither is he the son of man that he should repent. Amen. If you have your Bible today, I promised you a good word, and a good word I hope to deliver to you by the help of the Holy Spirit, because it's his word. If you have your Bible today, go to the book of Judges. We're going to go all the way back into Judges chapter 5, and I'll have you stand just in a second. But while I was in prayer this week, God began to speak to me very strongly about what COVID-19 has done. And it is a really great thing that's happening right now in the earth. And let me explain to you what's beginning to happen and bring you into the story of Judges chapter 5, which is Deborah. I want to talk to you about Deborah today. And show you what God is speaking to the church about. Don't get distracted. Whatever you do, don't get distracted right now. Don't get distracted in your faith. All of this is a distraction that's going on. All of it's a distraction to try to distract our faith. But we're not going to be distracted. We're going to stay true to what God said. Hallelujah. Amen. One thing COVID-19 has done, here's what God spoke to me. He said, I want to tell you, Peter, tell my people, it has brought down societal gods. All the gods of society are falling. All the gods of society are falling right before our very eyes. We have made gods of people. And God says they're all falling before our very eyes. And these things that we thought were significant and these people that we honored and we worshiped and we paid homage to, God said, I'm bringing all of that down right now. And I say, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered in the name. That's what he told me. He said, all of the societal gods are coming down. He said, all of the political gods are coming down. They're falling and they will drop like flies. Because now we have discovered that our politicians are not who we thought they were. Come on, somebody. We put hope in our politicians. We've made them high. And we placed them as our source. And now God is simply unveiling how corrupt that corruption really falls and how deep it is. Speak to me now. And those political gods that we clap for and we shout for at every campaign are now falling low. And we look at them and we frown upon them because we see that their intentions were never really pure in the first place. Speak to me now. And so now I feel what's happening in the nation of Canada is that God is allowing these political gods to fall before our very eyes, to say that I am the leader of Canada. God is the leader of Canada. God is the king of Canada. Come on, speak to me now. God is in charge of Canada. God is the hope of Canada. Sister Roseanne loves my word, bloviate. Our politicians have bloviated long enough. And now we realize it's empty promises. Speak to me now. You say, are you going to be political? I've got to, because Deborah was being political at her time. When you hear people say, oh, that preacher's political, then they haven't read their Bible. Because every man and woman of God that God raises up usually raises up against a political oppression and a spiritual oppression. But empty promises. And God is wooing the people of Canada back to him to say, my promises are not empty. And my intentions are not wicked. They're pure. I'll tell you another God that's falling is our entertainment gods. Come on, they're all falling, aren't we? The one thing COVID-19 has done is made us realize we don't need them in our lives. We don't need the movie stars and the actresses. We don't need Hollywood to survive. And now we've realized that Hollywood is just as corrupt as much of our politics today. And they are in cahoots with each other. They push a narrative that leads the land to unrighteousness. And those gods are falling before our very eyes. Oh yeah, for sure. Somebody say amen. We're not talking about their movies as much. We're not talking about their award ceremonies as much. We really could care less. There's more important things than this now. Our rock stars, all of that stuff is falling. And this one is falling too. And this one needed to fall quicker than any of them. Our religious gods are falling. Or how about this one? The gods that we put into the church that was not Jesus. I'm talking about the preachers that we have made gods of. That when COVID-19 hit, they ran and hid. And they were nowhere to be found. And that which we thought in the church was grandeur came down. And that which we thought in the church was simple came up. Amen. And this had to happen also. It'd be great if you paid attention. Hallelujah. Let's see God raise up a new generation of people who are standing strong. And realizing that the gods that we even made in the church, the ministry that we worshiped, and we failed to worship Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Come on. Come on. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Come on. I just feel God's presence right now. I really do. The only one is to be worshipped is Jesus. The only one is to be magnified is Jesus. And we thought all of these things were important. God said, no, they're all collapsing before your very eyes. And I'm bringing them down so that my son can rise up. Praise God. Hallelujah. And so we're seeing now the fall of the gods that man has made. We're also seeing the infallibility of man. How infallible man really is. And it's revealed the wickedness of man. That's what COVID-19 has revealed. And while I was waking up this morning, the Lord said to me very strong, and I put it on Facebook from what I heard God said. God told me very strong today that our nation has sought after leadership that would allow them to participate in sinful pleasure and infiltrate us in a sinful way. We have sought for those who would help us implement a sinful nature and put them in power and places of power so that they could allow us to do certain things that are contrary to the Word of God. And God said this nation has sought after that and went after that, and now the very ones they went after to implement sinful activity are the very people that are oppressing them today. And God said it's happened down through history and all human history. Somebody say, praise God, deliverance is coming. Come on, deliverance is coming. COVID-19 has revealed who really are true leaders. And we're finding they are not very many. There are not very many true leaders in the land today. And I really believe it's God now first working within His church to return us to be at full trust in Him. Trusting in God and having faith in God and putting our confidence back in God. Hallelujah. God would allow these things to happen to bring repentance back to the church first. God is allowing oppression to happen right now. Why? To get people to turn back to Him. Oh, come on now. Canada, you asked for Him and you got Him. You wanted a leader to give you sinful pleasure, and you got Him, and now He's oppressing you. But I'm here to tell you right now, Canada, the way out of this is to return to the living God. Come on, somebody, praise God. The Bible is a book of history. The Bible gives us story after story after story after story of history of when, and in the context of what's going on now, is that we see that in history that when the people wanted pleasure and they picked a king and a leader that would give them that contrary pleasure to the will of God, that king always turns on them and begins to oppress them. And that's what's happening in the land right now. But I'm here to tell you good news. When God woke me up this morning, He said, I'm raising up a righteous remnant that will combat this wickedness and take it to the ground. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And the Lord said, you will see a sweeping move across the nation of Canada where people will turn to God once again, and there'll be a cry to heaven for Canada to be completely set free, and it has already begun. It's begun. I said, it's begun. Hallelujah. God is moving in the land right now. Oh, God is moving. And the Lord says, you will see the oppressor rise to a pinnacle place, but suddenly collapse. That's what God says. And so, that's what's happening right now in the land. And then it's the same as in the days of the judges. And if you have your Bible, please grab it and stand to your feet once again. If you haven't been to the gym very often, we will make sure we work you out today. And stand to your feet and go to Judges chapter 5, verse 1. Then sang Deborah like you sang today, and Barak, the son of Abinoam, on the day saying, praise ye the Lord for the avenging of Israel, when the people willingly offered themselves. Hear you, O kings, and give ear, O you princes. I, even I, will sing unto the Lord. I will sing praise to the Lord God of Israel. That's what we did today. Come on, that's what we did today. God confirming his word. Verse 4, Lord, when thou wentest out of Seir, when thou marchest out of the field of Edom, the earth trembled and the heavens dropped, and the clouds also dropped water. The mountains melted from before the Lord, and even that Sinai from before the Lord God of Israel. In the days of Shamgar, the son of Anath, in the days of Jael, the highways were unoccupied, and the travelers walked through the byways. Meaning that in those days of oppression, the people hid in their houses. They were too afraid to go out on the streets of the affliction that Jael would bring, of Canaan would bring upon God's people. They were afraid. But here's what Deborah says. In the days of Shagar, the son of Anath, the days of Jael, the highways were unoccupied, and the travelers walked through the byways. The inhabitants of the villages ceased. They ceased in Israel until, oh, praise God. Say that with me, until. Come on, say it again, until. Well, listen, there's a whole lot of garbage going on. And people are in fear. And people feel oppressed. But until, when that until happens, a change is going to come. When that until happens, a change is going to come. And the Bible says, until that I, Deborah, and I arose, that I arose as the mother in Israel. Somebody give the Lord a shout of praise. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated. Let me get through this as fast as I can, because I want to bring you to this altar today, and I want us to give God praise for the deliverance of Canada. Oh, hallelujah. Because there's a battle right now between darkness and light. But I got good news for you. Light has never lost. This is a horrific time. A horrific time in Israel's history. They don't have a king. Now Ehud had just died, the second judge of the nation of Israel. He brought righteousness into the land. But when he died, the children of Israel were wanting other gods. Sound familiar? They wanted the gods of Canaan. They wanted the pleasures and the wickedness that was in Canaan and the evil. And the Bible says that when they sought after that, Jael of Canaan came in and began to oppress them. Sound familiar? And so as he was oppressing them for 20 years, he oppressed them. And he tormented them so much that they wouldn't even leave their house. They wouldn't go out on the streets. Jael caused his military to go after the people in order to keep them under his control. Sound familiar? Speak to me now. Sounds familiar, doesn't it? If they left their house, they were afraid to lose their lives and to lose their possessions. They were under the complete control of Jael because Jael had a leader, Sisera, who was the general of his army. And he was vicious. The Bible says that Sisera had 900 chariots of iron and weaponry that Israel did not have. Israel were foot soldiers. They had all of this military strength and power to put fear in the people, to drive them back from even opposing Jael's rule and oppression. Sound familiar? You got to know, even on Sunday, the other day, they brought UN troops in Ottawa to push our people back. So here they're trying to put fear. Jael's trying to put fear. He's using Sisera to put fear into the children of Israel because they brought it on themselves because they wanted the gods of Canaan. I'm here to tell you right now, Canada has brought it on itself because Canada has sought after the gods of secular humanism. And Canada has shut its doors to the gospel, to the word of God, to prayer in the schools. And now we have reaped leaders that are oppressive like Jael, who are using people like Sisera to push the people into oppression and push them back into their homes. We are in the same time. God said we're in the same time again. But I like what the Bible says. Deborah, by her own song of praise, said these things kept happening until I, Deborah, rose up as a mother to the nation of Israel. Woo! Deborah, a woman of God. All you men that don't think women should speak in the church should stop speaking yourself. Because God is not moved by male or female. God is moved by a heart that is consecrated unto Him. And if He can find Himself a woman or a man, that He can work through that vessel, then He will work through that vessel. And Deborah rose up as a great leader of the children of Israel. Deborah was an amazing, talented woman. She was a powerful woman. She was a leader. She was a judge. She was a prophetess. She was a wife, and she was a mother. And she said that until I rose up, praise God, Jael continued his oppression until I rose up like a mother to Israel. Are you ready for this one, ladies? No, you're not ready. Maybe I'll just... Can somebody check if my reservation can be early at the buffet? Amen. No. Here's what the Bible says. She said, I became a mother to my nation. And I mothered my nation back to putting its trust in God. And when I was praying this week, God told me that He needs people to rise up, especially the women of our church and the women of our generation, to mother this nation back to putting its trust in the living God. Speak to me now, ladies. Because many times a deliverer comes through a woman. When you see oppression in your Bible, you will find a woman that God has found in that situation. For example, everybody gives praise unto Moses, but it was his mother who gave birth to the deliverer, because she saw that God could deliver them from the tyranny of Egypt. When man needed a deliverer, God found a little 14-year-old girl named Mary, who was willing to allow deliverance to come through her. When God was looking for deliver Israel from the hands of Jael and from Sisera, He found Deborah. And Deborah found Barak. And she went to Barak up there in Naphtali, See, Deborah would hang out under the palm of Deborah, and people would come to her and ask her to judge between their affairs. And she would give righteous judgment of what people were to do in the land concerning their affairs. But God came to Deborah, and he told Deborah, I am going to deliver the children of Israel. And she went up to Naphtali, and she found Barak. And she said to Barak, God will surely use you to go out against the oppression of Jael and Sisera. And Barak said, I will do it. And he wasn't really that manly of a man, because he said to Deborah, I can't go unless you come with me. That's like a robber coming up to a couple on the street and a man go, you fight them. And take off running. Barak said, I need you to go with me. I understood why he wanted. She was the righteous judge. She was the prophetess. She was the one who had the revelation and the word of God for the nation of Israel. And they were going to be delivered from their gods and from the oppression that the gods brought. And the Bible says that Barak went out to battle against Sisera, and there was Deborah with him. And Sisera was driven by Barak all night long, and the chariots of Sisera, the 900 chariots, fled. And Sisera fled and found refuge in a tent of a woman. And because Barak did not go out by himself, Deborah turned to Barak and said, you will not receive the glory of this victory, but another woman will. Don't ever let a man in the church put you down, ladies. Amen. I got it. I have men come to me all the time, and they challenge me. Women should be silent in the church. And what I usually tell those men, then you go tell her that. I'm not telling her that. Okay, big boy. Go tell her to be silent, big boy. It'll be like a bobcat on you. How many men know what I'm talking about? You ever see those men that act tough when their wife are not around? And the moment she walks up, they go, oh, I'm sorry, did I say that? Woo, praise God. I love those men say, I'm the man of my house. And then I like to say to the lady, he said he was the man of the house. You said what? He's lying, honey. He's lying. He don't know what he's talking about. Pastor's lost his mind. I've had men come to me and say, why does Pastor Ellen preach in your church? Because she's a better preacher than you. Some of you men are looking at me, but God is calling you right now. See that? But you see, here it is. They drive out Sisera. They drive out Jael. And Sisera runs to hide in the tent of a woman. Is that God? Is that, whose phone is, it's Peggy again. You are a popular lady around here. You know what? It's a religious exemption letter. That's what it is. She said it's a religious exemption. Calling in the middle of service. Did you answer it? No, I should have answered. Yeah, there, let me answer.
It is.
We are in the middle of a service right now, brother. No, I'm kidding. Here's Peggy. Now, where was I? Sisera, this vicious man, was driven, and he went and hid in the tent of a woman to find refuge. And that woman, sorry, Jabin was the leader of Israel. Jael was the woman in the tent. I got that messed up, so let me correct that. Jabin and Sisera were the ones attacking Israel. Jael was the woman in the tent, prophesied by Deborah, who took a spike and drove it through the side of his head and took his life and ended the reign of Jabin over the children of Israel. What a way to die. So it was Jabin. Sorry, I need to clarify that. It was Jabin and Sisera who were the enemies of Israel. It was Jael who was the deliverer of Israel by taking out Sisera. And it was because Deborah saw her purpose. The church must see its purpose right now. And the church must, like Deborah, realize that we have been raised up to take the oppression down. And it is because we have rejected the gods of Canaan. We have rejected the gods of secular humanism. And we are looking again unto the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Somebody say, praise God. Deborah was raised up to break the oppression. And she did it by putting the people to trust in the Lord again. And Deborah, ready for this one? Deborah was a worshiping warrior. There's nowhere in the Bible that says that Deborah ever picked up a weapon. But she picked up a weapon of warfare that was not carnal, but it was mighty through God to the pulling down of the stronghold. While Barak was on the field with the weapons of war, Deborah was there worshiping God for the victory of Barak. Somebody say, praise God. God needs a church again to start praising Him and worshiping Him. And understand that it is a power that can transform Canada forever. Somebody praise God. This is why the enemy's trying to shut up the song on the streets of Ottawa. This is why there's such a battle between darkness and light. Because there are prayer warriors on the streets of Ottawa. There are praises going up on the streets of Ottawa. Our prime minister does not like it because he's controlled by a different force. But I'm here to tell you right now, the church must join in like Deborah and become worshiping and praising warriors right now and allow the salvation of God to come back to the land in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, praise God. And I'm telling you right now, it will come, and it is coming. Somebody say, it is coming. Because when the oppressor pushes with more threats, the oppressor realizes they are becoming powerless to a people who no longer fear them. Come on now. Come on now. They're realizing we don't fear them anymore. Woo! Praise God. We don't fear them no more. And that's what happened. You see, Sisera was so powerful, so strong, so many chariots, so many weapons of war that he terrified for 20 years. The children of Israel, that they would not go out and battle for themselves to regain their freedom. But God found a worshiping warrior who realized that her source was heaven and was God alone. I'm telling you right now, a person that trusts God is not in fear of man. And our drama high school teacher is realizing people are not afraid of him. And because he was born with a silver spoon in his mouth, he's having a temper tantrum. But I'm here to tell you right now, God is on the march. God is on the move. People are rising up. because they are putting their trust back in the living God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God, like Deborah. Somebody say amen, amen, amen. Woo! It's happening, it's happening, it's happening. I want to give you real quick. Trust is to have faith. That's why God said, wrap your faith around what I said. Wrap your faith around what I said. Wrap your confession, your praise, your worship, your prayer, everything that you do in the context of the gift and the spirit of faith upon what I said. And see that I am God, and I will be exalted, according to what David said in Psalms 46:10. I am God, and I will be exalted amongst the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Somebody say, praise God. As I look even at these leaders now, I look at them and go, look how minuscule they really are now. And as God arises in the heart of Canadian people and rises in the heart of the church, more importantly again, there'll be a strength in us like Deborah. And women, we need you to rise up like Deborah right now. Come on, ladies, we need you to rise up like Deborah right now. We need mothers, we need wives. We need prophetesses, we need judges. We need women of God who can call on God and who know who their God is. Come on, there's a strength in a woman. There's a strength in a woman. Women can go through pain. Women can go through hardship with a child in one hand and a child in the other hand and stir the pot on the stove with their right leg at the same time and pray down heaven right in their kitchen as they are worshiping warriors unto the living God. Is that you? She's like, that's me. We need some Deborahs right now. Come on, we need some Deborahs right now. We don't need feminists right now. We need some Deborahs right now. We need some women of God who know their God, who know that God can deliver their land and deliver their children. Oh, hallelujah. Somebody say, praise God. Oh, I got to get done. Proverbs 29:25, the fear of man lays a snare, and they know it. Like Jabin, he knew it. To fear Sisera was to fear him, and it was a snare. But whoever trusts in the Lord shall always be safe, the Bible says. God knows. Why do we trust him? Because God knows what's coming next. God knows what will happen next. And the Bible says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make our path very straight right now. Oh, praise God. For all of our truckers, we stand in prayer. And we are worshiping warriors on your behalf that God would deliver you from the hand of oppression, and everything that was stolen from you shall be returned unto you, and you shall have more than you had before it all began in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody say, praise God. Why did she trust? Why was she a worshiping God? Because she trusted God. Because she knew who God was. And she knew that God was bigger than Jabin and Sisera and the 900 chariots. She knew that what would happen next was something spectacular. Why? Because she heard from God. And God told her that Barak would go up and deliver Israel. I'm here to tell you right now, the prophets are speaking. There's coming a change of the guard in Canada. The victory is guaranteed. The victory is guaranteed. The prophets have spoken. The outcome is true, and it is sure. And now we trust God. And next thing is, she did not fear bad news. She didn't let bad news make her afraid. Oh, Sisera has come with all of the chariots. Bad news does not move a man or a woman of God, especially a worshiping warrior. Because a worshiping warrior knows the moment you start praising, God starts showing up. Come on, hallelujah. They would love for us to sit on our pews and hide in fear right now, but I refuse to allow them to put us into fear. I will rejoice in the goodness of God. I will dance in this place and celebrate the victory, because if God said it, it will happen, because God is able to make it go through. She didn't fear bad news. She didn't fear bad news. Look to your neighbor and say, never fear bad news. The Bible says he is not afraid of bad news. He and she is not afraid of bad news, because their heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. You look on the news this week, you would think we're in trouble. But really, it's simply a part of God's plan. Because we prophesied to you that their hearts would become hardened and they would increase their attack, but that God would allow them in their own pride and arrogance to bring it all down. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Let a revival flow in the land. Canada is being saved. Canada is being saved. Come on, Canada is being saved. Say it, Canada is being saved. She did not fear bad news, because she knew there was going to be a war between darkness and light. Because she understood that the enemy of darkness never surrenders voluntarily and will always push its hardest at its weakest point. The enemy will always push their hardest at their weakest point. When Jesus was on the cross, they did everything they could to stop him. But I'm telling you right now, the enemy was getting defeated because the enemy at its weakest point always pushes. And I'm here to tell you, we're in a battle between darkness and light right now. What we witnessed in our nation right now is disheartening, because we're watching darkness. To watch peaceful protesters being beaten for just standing there. Is there trying to exert strength to put fear back in the people, but the people are no longer afraid. And the battle of darkness and light has happened. But I'm here to tell you right now, light always prevails over the darkness. Come on, light always prevails over the darkness. And one thing history has told us, every oppressive work of the enemy always collapses. Oh, come on, somebody. The church, we are the Deborah. We are the Deborah of the land. We are the Deborah of the land. Well, not all the church, but there are major parts of the church. We are the Deborah of the land. We are the worshiping warriors. Come on, we are the worshiping warriors. We are the Miriams who pick up the tambourine and beat that thing for the victory of Israel. We are the Deborahs, the worshiping warriors. Hallelujah. We are the worshiping warriors. We are the ones that when we praise God, God shows up. Oh, hallelujah. She knew that God was with her. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous hand, God said. She knew that. She knew that. That's why she went on the battlefield. She didn't go on the battlefield saying to her kids, maybe mama will be home. She went on the battlefield knowing that she was going to be home to cook dinner. Do you know why? Because she knew that God had already promised her the victory. All she needed to do is praise Him until it manifested. Will you lift up your hands and bless the Lord? Come on. Come on, will you lift up your hands and bless the Lord? Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. I know we're going a little longer, but we're in a battle right now. And sometimes you just got to get things done. Amen? Come on, will you give God praise right now? Praise Him. I got two more points. Praise Him. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is the deliverer of Canada. Our God is the deliverer of the people. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. She knew not only God was with her, she knew God was working for her good. I want you to get this in our spirit, and I want to get this in our spirit. As I sat at my desk before I came out, and I was praying, give me something a little more exciting. Nobody died around here, brother. Hallelujah. God, while I was at my desk, God said this to me. God said, tell my people that I have not planned any defeats for them. I have not planned any defeats for them. Pastor Ralph will tell you, when he came to my office, I was pacing back and forth. I was pacing back and forth around my office, just walking around the office, talking to God, saying, God, the victory is absolute now. The victory is assured right now. The victory shall come before the coming of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because you have not planned any defeats for us. You have not planned for our defeat. You have planned our victory. Somebody give God a praise. Amen. For we know that all things work for good. And we know that in all things God works for good for those who love Him and who have been called according to His purpose. Oh, praise God. God is the safe place. Trust in God like Deborah and not in things. Trust in God and not in things. She trusted God and not people. She trusted God and she kept focused on Him. And she trusted God and the blessing came through that worshiping warrior, Deborah. The blessing shall come through the Deborah of Canada, which is the Church of the Living. Stand to our feet, everybody. Pastor, please come. Pastor, please come. Praise God. Can you give God praise, everybody? Say this with me. Say this with me. Blessed is the one. Oh, you're going to do better than that. Come on. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. Is that you? Is that the church? Is that the Deborah of Canada? Then shout, we are blessed of God. Come on, shout, we are blessed of God. Shout, Canada shall be blessed. Pastor, God bless you, Pastor. Give the Lord a praise, everybody. Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh.
Hallelujah.
He's fired up there.
Praise God.
Preach like that. Taking Deborah, letting her rise up in this hour.
But as I was sitting there, I just felt the Lord made known, I have not only spiritual Deborahs, I will raise up in Canada a woman of great influence. Soon she shall arise with national recognition. Oh, I feel that. It's tingling all over me. Who shall this woman be? The Lord said, I have prepared her for a long time. She will speak as my voice. She is anointed, and I have appointed her. She will arise in this nation of Canada. Mark it down, soon shall this thing be. Oh, hallelujah. She fears not man, but fears only the Lord God of heaven. Hallelujah. Another Deborah is coming forth in this nation.
Yes.
The oppression is being crushed. Yes. Oh, you Hallelujah. Had it right there, Pastor.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank God. There is a breakthrough over this nation. I know many have been feeling that oppression, but not in this house today. For we know how to worship God. We're worshiping warriors.
Yes, yes, we are.
As you began your message, you talked about praise and singing and worship. That always prepares us for the next level of God's operation.
Yes.
You cannot go out in battle without being a worshiper.
That's right.
And those who know how to connect with God. Oh, we're not talking about singers. We're talking about worshipers.
That's right.
Worshipers who know how to sing.
Right.
Because I've seen musicians and singers, they haven't got it, nothing happens. But you get them worshiping, then singing, then playing,
yes.
then glorifying God. Yes. You know what I'm talking about. You know how to move
yeah.
in it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. Victory. Oh, victory is mine. Victory, oh, victory is mine. Well, if I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battle. Oh, victory is mine. Oh, yes, victory, oh, victory is mine. Well, victory, oh, victory is mine. Well, if I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battle.
Oh, victory is mine.
You feel it? Come on.
Well, victory, oh, victory is mine.
Hallelujah.
Victory, oh, victory is mine.
Well, if I hold my I know how the enemy will try to suppress us. But when these dear sisters got out here, when you were singing, they started to dance. I said, devil, you're not taking the dance out of my feet. So I joined them. Hallelujah. The devil will try to take the song out of your heart. He'll try to take the praise off your lips. He'll try to take the dance out of your feet. But when you know victory is yours, you'll be able to celebrate. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, Pastor Sam. Come up here. On your wives. Bring them up here. Yeah, bring up here. Come on. Pastor Ellie, come up here. Hallelujah. Come right up here. Come on. Oh, oh, yeah. Sing it now. Victory, oh,
victory.
Victory,
oh, victory is mine.
Oh, well,
if I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battles.
Victory. it up, saints. Come out and celebrate here. Some of you. Let's dance. Celebrate the goodness of God. Some of you went at the wedding. Some of you, when you were at a wedding and YMCA came on, you jump out and dance. Now you won't dance. Come on. Nudge your neighbor, say, move your feet and give God praise. Let's be worshiping and praising warriors today. Come on. Canada, victory is at hand. Come on. Canada's victory is at hand. Say it again. Canada's victory is at hand. Can you give the Lord a shout of praise? I want Pastor to pray over you, and then we're going to go out shouting and praising God. Would that be okay? Praise God. Skip, you can dance with those crutches, man. Look at him. I'm teasing him. He's kicking right now. Be careful. Come on, let's let the blessing of the Lord be upon you.
It's awesome. There is so much victory. Hallelujah. All oppression and the oppressors are being brought down quickly. It shall happen as swift as the wind that blows across the sea. Hallelujah. Oh, I was reminded, Pastor, and I've mentioned it a couple times, that it was right here, that man can measure the strength of the wind in categories, even 1 to 5. But I've got a wind, saith the Lord, that I will release over the nations that men cannot measure. That wind has begun to blow across the nations, not only here in Canada. God has used Canada to spark nations, and it's happening. All the nations around are being stirred. This is a movement of God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for the wind that is blowing across this land, and that you're doing an awesome work. You're tearing down, you're rooting up, but you're also going to raise up. You're doing an awesome work, oh God, and we thank you for that which you are doing even now before our very eyes. We see the mighty God. We see the great wind blowing across the land and around the world. You are God, and you're God alone. And we rejoice in you, and we celebrate the greatness of your love. And we shout out victory in the name of Jesus. And the people shouted amen.
Skip, come here. We want to pray for you right now. Come. We want to pray for him. No, Skip, we'll pray for you if you'd like. But she's like, me? I want to be prayed for. What happened? You got crushed by a forklift. Well, we're gonna believe God for a complete miracle. They put plates in your leg or something? You broke 2 bones. Well, we're going to ask the Lord to put those bones back together right now. Come on. How many believe God can give us a miracle for Skip right now? How many believe that right now? Come on. Stretch your hands right now. Father, in the name of Jesus. Come on, church. Pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, the miracle-working Jesus, the powerful name of Jesus, we command the bones in these legs to come back together
and not any indication of a break has ever occurred in this leg. God, I give you praise right now for healing our brother with a brand new leg, and the pain goes and the bones come back together in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, worshiping warriors, give God praise for the miracle. Oh, that's not good enough. Come on, give God praise for the miracle. Lord, we give you the praise and the glory for this miracle in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless our brother with a miracle today for the glory of God. And everybody shouted. Are you ready to praise him before you go? God bless you. Let's praise the Lord in here.
All under God's, they are the works of men, but you are the Most High God.
There is none like you.
All other gods in
all other gods, and they are the works of men,
but you are the Most High God.
Command my hands to praise the Lord. Yeah. to praise the Lord.
Listen, listen, they did it in Ottawa. I just feel, let's do it by faith in Hamilton. Who will joy start it, march around the church one time and give God praise that the walls of Jericho are coming down in the nation? Who? Raphael, go ahead and start it, Raphael. Let's praise the Lord in this house. Come on, hallelujah. The walls are coming down in Canada. Canada's being saved. Woo, praise God.
My God is good, oh.
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 Everything that double, double, oh.
My God is good, oh.
Anointing double, double, oh.
My God is good, oh.
Double, double,
my God is good, oh.
So good.